Hello everyone, so we'll be discussing GS mains paper 1 of UPSC mains 2018, right? We'll try to discuss it. And it was a very interesting paper with very interesting distribution of questions. Fine. So again, the pattern we know, there are 10 questions of 10 marks and 10 questions of 15 marks. So they have not changed anything regarding it. Like in last year also, they have changed the pattern and this year they have stuck to it. Generally, there was an apprehension that certain people were feeling that they will revert back to 12.5 marker. They have not done that. Now this paper, GS Mains paper 1, if you see it, because various sites have shared it, if you see it, you will realize that world history is more or less absent in this GS Mains paper. Only if I was there, and one more thing, when I was there, I was giving this paper, so I know how our mind works in those 3 hours, and it is totally different from when people are analyzing it from outside, right? It doesn't work like that. In 3 hours, time is very less and we think in a particular order, right? So sometimes what happens, people outside, they feel that our question was very easy, but it was not easy for us because time constraint was the major issue, right? So again, I am telling you my view, what questions I found difficult. I have history optional, so there were certain questions like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This question was found tough by maximum people, but since I had an history option, so I find it okay. But again, geography optional people, I have talked to some of them, they were like mental plumb was a very easy question, dead zone was easy for them. I found those questions tough. So again, it is a give or take. If I got benefited because of my history optional in one or two questions, I was harmed also because the geography optional people were benefited in some other ways, right? It works like that. Again, one more question was there of PC culture. And people have we've talked about fishing and all those things. See, PC culture is when you are cultivating fish in specific tanks, and it is a part of inland fishing, right? Even what do you say, it is a subset of inland fishing, so you have to talk about specific these things, right? So that's why it was a tricky question. It was one of the parts. The second part of this question was defining blue revolution, so again that was very tricky. Sociology dominated this paper. Social aspects, we know that in GS1 social aspect is there, right? So sociology more or less dominated GS paper 1. If I talk about what are the different questions of sociology are there, there are plenty questions are there which are on sociology, right? Caste system is there. Caste system is assuming new identities and associational forms, and caste system cannot be eradicated in India. It was a social question, right? But again, you can add an elements of history in it, because I have wrote that new identities in caste system started in the postmodern period with the initiation of Rath Stoma sacrifice, which is given in Manuspriti. And then you can talk about different associational forms in caste system. Like we have Kankuj Brahman, we have Mathil Brahman. So we are developing caste within caste, and these are new identities, right? And you can also talk about different cash incentives introduced by government to promote inter-caste marriages. Okay, so this was one social based question. Again, there was one question on eradication of poverty, and again there was one question on there was one question on core strategies for transformation and aspirational districts, women's movement in India, and communalism arises. So lots and lots of questions on socialism, so I mean social aspects. So yeah, sociology more or less dominated, history was there. Geography was very less in numbers, pure geography. World history, I'm seeing only one question on world history, which is directly or indirectly related to world history, was endangered labor. Why endangered labor was taken by the British from India to other colonies, and have they been able to preserve their cultural identity over there? If this particular question only has a tinge of world history in it, otherwise more or less world history was absent. So again, GS paper 1, I found it little unconventional. When we will discuss GS paper 2, you will see that it is more or less conventional, right? Even there, theoretical parts are being asked, but GS 1 was little bit unconventional. Also, GS 3 is also unconventional. We will discuss that. So again, marks can dip as compared to last year, but again, I am not very sure. I am also giving this exam, so let's see what happens. But I am very sure that the paper was very unconventional and certain aspects were very generic in nature. So you cannot predict how many marks you will get until or unless final score comes, right? Okay, so this was my analysis, and after that I will analyze GS paper 2 also, right? Thank you.